First of all, I want to say that I really enjoyed my group this time. I have never enjoyed any group before that. I'm kidding. Come on. But I really enjoyed some of the insight and feedback that my group gave. I'm going to start off with a quote that I just got today. From someone's grandfather on campus. I don't want to like embarrass this person. I won't point her out. He said, "A neighbor is anyone who has a need that I can meet." Yeah, I mean, it's simple, to the point. I love it. I love Papa Fetters. You do too, I assume. There are plenty of needs that I'm sure we saw in our pictures. For example, this guy right here. We all probably talked about his basic needs, the necessities, survival needs, shoes, warm clothes, a meal, things of that sort. Go to the next page. I really enjoyed some of the points that my group brought up. They said, in this situation, the little girl has needs that we can meet. And I said, like what? You know, being a friend, things like that. They agreed. One of my group members said that the parents are probably not as much meeting the needs as maybe being a source of creating emotional needs that this girl would have. Do you guys probably agree with that? I know, me personally, I was raised in a divorced home, and I had to go through a lot of issues, you know, trust, things like that, that I feel were kind of sparked by my parents' conflict, being raised in a house where there was shouting, yelling, things like that. You know what I mean, Cole? Yeah? Then there's this guy. Pretty nice kitchen. I told my group that, you know, he probably needs an interior decorator and a haircut, but the question came up, what exactly are his needs? Because they're different than the guy number one. He looks like he's got all of his survival needs taken care of. He looks like he's got food, just maybe a little bit bored. And I was thinking, yes, but are we taking consideration the emotional needs that this guy has, the spiritual ones? And maybe guy on picture number one wouldn't have as many physical needs if some of his emotional and spiritual needs were being met. So there's also the last page, which if you've seen the help, is Minnie and Abilene. I will get to them in a second. I spent some time thinking, praying about what exactly I wanted to talk to you guys about in terms of needs. And I'm going to tell you straight up, I believe that you guys have a keen eye for seeing needs. I also believe that you can meet those needs. In fact, if I didn't believe in this room's ability to transform Huntington North High School, then I would not be doing campus life, because it would be a waste of my time. That is how much I believe that you guys can meet needs. So I began to think, what exactly is preventing all of us from not just seeing the needs, but meeting them? I began to think about these emotional needs that we were talking about. The building of people up, building people up, encouraging them, these emotional needs, saying, I see that you are hurting and I want to encourage you. I want to say positive, uplifting things to you. You've got this, raising people up over here, and on the opposite end of the spectrum that a lot of us constantly succumb to is tearing people down. Back to Minnie and Abilene. In order to know what needs they have, we have to know what their struggle is. There is a character, if you've seen the movie, named Hilly. Okay? She is nasty. She is mean. She is cruel. She's manipulative. She treats these two women like they have no value and no worth. She treats them like they're animals. And one of the best parts in the movie is when Abilene, this woman that looks so content, who is actually fed up throughout the entire movie, goes up to her and she says, "Hilly, you are a godless woman." It is, oh man, I was getting goosebumps. Like, yes, you tell her she's a godless woman. She is basically saying, you claim to be a Christian, but nothing that you do looks like Christ, this God that you talk about, that you want to represent. I don't see him in anything that you do. And guys, what is tearing people down? It's not just treating them the way that these women were treated in a movie. It's gossiping. It's talking poorly about people. And you might not ever hear someone say to your face, you are a godless person, but they might be asking their friends, I thought that this guy or this girl was a Christian, that they represented something that was uplifting, and I don't see that in what they do. And I just want you to think about that. And if you are not a Christian, I want you to ask these people that are slandering behind people's back, just say, I thought that you were a Christian. Like, are you, should you be talking about that person like this? So I am charging both ends of the spectrum, Christians, non-Christians. Help us change Huntington North. And I do believe that that can happen. Thessalonians 5:11 says, therefore, encourage one another, building each other up. Thessalonians is a very short book. If you have a chance to read it, I encourage you to read it because it's encouraging. And it's about encouraging people and how Paul is encouraged by the encouragement of others. A lot of his books are kind of like, ooh, wow, these people are not doing so well. I just want to say, maybe check it out. So that is pretty much it. And I hope that we can see needs, emotional, physical. There are programs. We were talking about Boys and Girls Club, Huntington Houses, stuff like that. There's a lot of opportunities around here. So that is pretty much it. Okay, I think we have announcements.
So if you guys have any questions,